Hello.
Hello.
This is the Crazy
Hello.
Man and Alex3527, and we're going to play Firefight and come to our conclusional thoughts in the Thoughts On series about Halo 5 Guardians.
Yes, we are. And because we're playing Halo Reach, you can probably guess what our final opinions are. Stop them
in their tracks. Yeah, pretty much. Alright. It looks like it's possible that this is a little bit loud, so I'm going to turn it down.
Also, it's laggy on the Xbox One, but...
Yes, we know this already.
Yes, but it's more laggy than... I don't know.
It's more laggy than Halo 5 Guardians, I guess.
Which is impressive.
It's a little bit impressive, actually.
Oh gosh, I'm lagging so hard.
I'm not lagging, but there's just a lot of fingers.
I guess frame rate drop is, it's like 15 right now.
Okay, Jesus, we're concentrating on the game too much.
Yes. Because, I don't know. This is so effing hard right now.
I'm just gonna shotgun my way out of all my problems. What?
At least I will with this kind of leg.
What? Alright. So,
Alright.
I guess that we can start with our, you want to start with our final conclusions and come to, and show how we came to them?
Maybe we could break it down into a few different parts, and then come to an overall.
Alright, well, I guess then we would do pros and cons of good old Halo 5 Guardians, which is neither good nor old.
Different parts of Halo 5, like the multiplayer campaign, custom games, Forge.
Well, yeah, that would be like a pros and cons thing. You say, like, this is good, this is bad kind of thing.
Yeah.
Alright, so, I guess that we always, people like to start with good things, I'll start with bad things, because fuck people. I would say that the worst parts are, for some people, theater mode does not work, and the game constantly kicks you out of matches, and it has kicked me out of matches as well, despite my relatively high quality connection to the good old internet. The game seems to require a really high value internet connection, which I don't even possess, for an actual ability to play the darn game.
It's pretty much the worst I've yet dealt. I'm able to play matchmaking most of the time, but Forge is unplayable.
Oh. Yeah. Like, it seems that people with bad internet connection have, like, one game type that strangely does not function in the slightest. You know? Like, it just keeps kicking them out over and over and over again. The servers don't really seem to be... Like I was saying, the servers don't really seem to be too nice to people. There is, at this point, I think that we can conclusively say that there is a large lack of content in the game compared to most Halo games. This game succeeds to have less like game types and maps than even Halo 1. So, I would say it's pretty low level for a Halo game.
It's like 343 is replacing true content with rec items that only part of the community ever uses, and also they're just kinda not cool.
Yeah, and then there's like the rec system, which replaces the ranking up and the normal ranking up and armor system, and I would say that it's a complete failure.
It's disgusting.
Yeah, it's absolutely atrocious. It's just bad behavior by a company that should be giving us their all.
Yeah, it seems like the entire rec system is based around using the game to farm money from children who can get any amount of it from their parents.
And I would say that since we're on the multiplayer, subject, let's see what else. We still do not have an in-browser file share system, in-game file share system, which is vital to any Halo game that wants to actually have decent custom games.
On the custom games, it is hard to get to a custom game.
Well, yeah, that contributes to it.
But because they don't...
And I would also say that another thing is that negative thing for multiplayer is that there is no Halo. You get to, before loading into each match, you get to look at each map and vote for them. They've removed the ability to vote for maps, which is a classic Halo thing that Halo has always had. And it's kind of just stupid to remove it because the 343 maps, some of them are really bad and I don't want to play them. So it really kind of annoys me that it just has this automatic matchmaking that doesn't let me see or do anything. And it doesn't let you see other players in the match. You can't look at other people's armor to, like, admire or look at them and be like, oh, this guy is, like, a noob or something.
You can, but you have to go into recent players and then click on their names individually.
Well, it's only an option available after the game.
Yeah.
And even then, if the game's end lobby system used to be atrocious when we were playing it, the end result screen would never load in. So you would never, half the time, it would never even record that your game existed in the recent players, so you'd never get to even know who you played with last.
Yeah.
And another thing, speaking of the challenge that just came up, Blastin' and Relaxin' in Halo Reach, I am reminded that Halo 5 Guardians does not possess challenges, which the last... three Halo games, if you use some of the Halo 3 websites, had challenges. Challenges is a classic Bungie invention, and it would be very nostalgic for them to be able to bring them back, especially with the good names that that Bungie has. Speaking of names, the game Halo 5 has absolutely horrible names for just about everything that you can think of. The armor. The armor, the maps, the descriptions of everything do not match. Nothing matches up. This time, different from Halo 5, I would say that like the aesthetics all match up. From Halo 4. I think that Halo 4 had some leftover aesthetics from Halo Reach that made the game look a lot worse than it should have. But like overall, there's just a lot of mismatched stuff. Like there's Halo 1 pistols in Halo 5, and there's like, they don't really spend any time making the weapons look. The rec items, they don't like match their descriptions. They don't spend any time on the names. The names don't really match.
Oh yeah, they give them this fake ass backstory, but and they're like. Oh yeah, Captain Dick Butts of the Honor Guard Squad flies a Banshee with a yellow triangle on its butt.
Exactly. That's about a pretty good description. It's just like random shit that they pulled out of their ass for a description of anything, just about anything in the game. And this kind of thing somehow excuses itself for like rec items, DLC rec items that they say would replace normal DLC, right? Which I don't think it replaces normal DLC. I just think it gives them an excuse to not do shit.
They do give us these maps, but they're really mediocre maps.
Well, once again, the maps descriptions don't match the maps at all.
Okay, there's nothing like the Halo 3 and Halo Reach really creative descriptions that maps used to have.
Yeah, they remind me exactly of the Halo 4. You remember the Halo 4 DLC maps where everybody bought the DLC because they all had the season pass, but like
the Pit remake was decent.
It sucked. Like the majority of the maps sucked sucked, basically. And the only one that was good, one of the only ones that was good was the Pit remake at the end.
I like that one green big team battle one, but it was really hit or miss whether or not people actually liked
it. Well, it wasn't really balanced map. Well, yeah, no, it was. Yeah.
It
depended on the players because, you know, in Halo 4, you rushed for the Mantis in every single match, if you remember. So,
Yeah. Basically,
if, like, you had a team where everybody was like, oh, let's get the Mantis and get a perfection, then the game would be completely ruined. But if you were just, like, with a bunch of players were like, who gives a shit about the Mantis because it kind of sucks anyway, and we don't like it, then they just, like, and they leave it alone, then the match was perfectly fine.
I don't know. Mantis on Mantis battles were fun. The problem is when people would just camp around for Mantises and they betray people and
they would generally be useless to their team. But that's beside the point. We're talking about Halo 5 here. So you think that we've gotten to all the important negative things? Yes. The campaign.
The game is about as balanced as Halo Reach is, except it's way faster paced, so that's a bit of an issue.
Yeah.
And plus, Halo Reach was supposed to be casual in the multiplayer, and Halo 5 is supposed to be super competitive. And I mean, in Arena Slayer, it's fine, but once you include vehicles, it gets absolutely thrown to shit.
Well, the way that the campaign is the way that the multiplayer is, they don't have like any playlists for classic players that just want to play, big team battle. So like
competitive game with vehicles, it's not possible.
Yeah, there's like nothing. There's nothing for the casual players like me and Alex where we just want to go fight. In Halo.
But I want it to at least be balanced.
Yeah, like, they don't have a version of the game that doesn't have sprint, or they, even though you can remove sprint from the game, thankfully, this time.
I want to exactly be BTB, but, why is there no classic playlist? That's ridiculous, also.
There should be, like, 100 classic playlists, you know? Like, there should be, like, you know, SWAT with pistols.
Oh, yeah, why isn't there a SWAT classic? That'd be awesome too.
Yeah, I would love that. Because the thing that I don't like is that the mobility, especially in SWAT, the mobility abilities in Halo 5 Guardians kind of just distract you from the main, or kind of distracting from the main gameplay, and they end up kind of hurting your performance a lot. If you actually, it's weird because if you actually play with the old Halo strategies, you can do, at least for me, I can do a lot better than if I ever tried to use any of the million craps that you get with your Spartan nowadays. Okay, I think that the Spartan abilities thing was cool, but it's just like so far from like actual Halo that it's just boring, you know, for me.
I mean, yeah, it doesn't. Like, I understand them trying to change up the game, but I do not understand them not having classic playlists. So that's a huge down for me.
Yes. I would say that, of course, next there's the ever-missing firefight, the ever-missing invasion. All the playlists that should have already been in the game took forever to be added, and some of them aren't even permanent. Like, for example, it took them forever in 1 to ever add DMR SWAT, and then it disappeared about a week after they came out with it, and I didn't even get to ever play it, because I was gone.
Yeah, how about the fact that they still don't have a real action sack?
Yeah, they got rid of the action sack playlist after they put it in. They have this strange weekend thing where there's only, like, 5 playlists in the entire... There's only 8 playlists in Arena now, which makes, like, 10 playlists total in the entire game, small matchmaking, which is the only thing you can do because the campaign is so bad. There's nothing you can really do there, and Firefight doesn't exist. Their only excuse for Firefight is absolute garbage. you know, Warzone is not interesting at all, and there aren't any maps. And you aren't allowed to forge Warzone maps, which is complete BS, I think.
Dude, if you could forge Warzone Firefight, that would be an absolute game changer. Also, the Firefight in Warzone was more of a disappointment than a feature, because when Warzone first came out, people were predicting, oh, hey, I see how this becomes Firefight, that's really easy. And then they spent half a year making it themselves, and they made something mediocre.
I mean, basically a sum up of the multiplayer is that there's a million and one things that they haven't added that should have been in the game at the beginning. That's basically the idea, I would say. And for the, what do you think about the campaign?
I've played through it about twice now. I forgot that I was working on the Legendary Camp. It's fun to play, kind of, but, the replay value is so kind of meh.
Well, I would say that there's not more than a few missions that actually accomplish. I think there's not more than two missions that accomplish the goal that every Halo game normally does, which is that there are missions that you actually want to play again.
Yeah, I never want to play an individual mission again. I either want to play the whole campaign over again or not at all.
Yes, it reminds me very much of Halo 4, where the campaign was just so meh. And like the storytelling was just so bland. Except for in Halo 4, it was kind of offensive, but like this time, it's just so neutral. It's such a neutral way to tell that story, you know. Like it's the kind of thing I would expect from like it was. It's the kind of thing that I would expect as like the playtest for the camp. Like Halo 5's campaign.
Yeah.
It makes me think of like what Project Contingency's playtest for their campaign might have looked like a year ago. That's what it reminds me of.
Now the thing is, the only reason the campaign is offensive is because of the Hunt the Truth stuff that's made us think that this was going to be an absolutely groundbreaking campaign.
Well, I thought the Hunt the Truth stuff, I thought it was interesting, but the problem that I had was that I knew that 343 wasn't going to be able to make it happen. Like, and my other biggest problem was that the entire premise of the thing, which was that you were supposed to hunt down and, like, kill the Master Chief, was stupid, because nobody's going to be able to do it, you know? If they did, then that would just be, like, the stupidest ending to a character in history. You know?
Well, no, I don't know that anyone really thought that the Master Chief would die.
Yeah, that's why I didn't really care much for that whole Hunt the Truth thing, apart from season
but Hunt
1.
That was the other one.
No, that was what Hunt the Truth was about, Alex.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that was part of the Hunt the Truth.
The second season had nothing to do with Chief. That was what you're thinking about.
No, the part of Hunt the Truth I liked was the fact that, I think it was Oni was turning against the Outer Colonies, and that was something I wanted to see more of.
To be honest, like, the way that they were doing the Hunt to Truth
and
thing...
At least they mentioned the Outer Colonies, but, like, not really.
What I would have really liked is if, like, that Hunt the Truth thing was, like, if that was the campaign, you know, where you, like, because I don't really care that... I know that I'm, like, a strange guy, but I don't really care that much about playing the Master Chief all that much. I mean, I know that was the major criticism of the Halo 5 campaign, but that wasn't really my problem. Like, I would have loved, like, a campaign where you played, like, a whole different guy that was like, finding out the truth about Master Chief from, like, after being in a company that was, like, all about propaganda about him and the UNSC. Like, that would have been a really cool game, and then you would get to play Chief and, like, you would get to play Chief in these conflicts to find out what really happened at the end. Like, wouldn't that be the greatest thing?
Yeah, that would actually be pretty good. Now, do you want to get to the positives yet?
Oh, yeah, sure. I think that we've listed off plenty of things.
We haven't come up with one positive.
No, we weren't trying to, though.
I know. The new Warthogs are cool. I'd like to see them in custom games.
Yeah, the vehicle gameplay is a lot better than last time, especially in the campaign. They made sure to add a lot of vehicle gameplay that was really good. Like the
The vehicle gameplay isn't balanced in most of the game, it feels like.
Well, that's the problem. I think the reason why it isn't balanced is because then otherwise the wrecks wouldn't be worth the same amount that they have them right now. That's one of the biggest problems about the vehicle gameplay is that it's all locked behind wrecks.
Your comment is still valid. But the non-wrecked vehicles feel so crappy.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say. Like, that's the point.
Although a few of them feel OP compared to the other non-wrecked vehicles. Mainly, the Phaeton cannot be taken out by almost any other non-wrecked vehicle.
Right. I would say that the Phaeton was pretty disappointing, but that's a whole other thing.
But the Needler Warthog, that brings high hopes for the next Halo game, for Halo 6, where they might have a new take on that and have it as an actual base Warthog.
Yeah, basically they need to abandon everything good about the game is kind of sucked into the rec pack area, I would say. Because they have some really cool guns, and they have some historical guns from Halo, and they have some really great vehicles. But all of it's locked behind wrecks. You can't use it in Forge most of the time. The only things that you can use are some of the mythics, and that really disappoints me because I want like a custom games lobby where it's all the high rec level weapons in like a giant tournament of Fiesta fight, that would be great. And with like low gravity and shit, oh man, But you can't do that because they've locked all the goods. They've locked the majority of all the good content behind the rec packs,
Yeah.
Like for me, I would love to have that Halo Reach armor, and I would love to work for it. But because it's in the rec system and there's no guarantee of me ever getting it, then I don't give a shit, It makes a lot of people not care about Halo 5 because the content that they want to play is locked behind things that they would never spend the time getting because the game just isn't good enough,
Yeah.
I mean, there's no reason for me to have any of that armor,
So, another positive,
I know, we kind of spawned that as a negative. I apologize for that. I still think that there are a lot of cool things that they did with that. I think that this time they made the mobility with the sprint work. Like, they actually have maps where sprint actually fucking makes sense, Instead of in Halo 4 where they built a bunch of classic maps that made no sense for sprint and it kind of ruined the gameplay.
Yeah.
I like the fact that loadouts were removed from,
Oh yeah, loadouts being removed, that was a great choice. Good. Even starts, the game is way more competitive in the 4v4 arena.
Yeah, I would say that the parts of arena that should be competitive are competitive, although I would also note that it continues on into places that shouldn't be competitive in the slightest.
Forge objects. They've added lots of Forge objects that we've never had before that we always wanted.
Oh yes, yes. The Forge is great. The Forge design team is clearly know exactly what we want for Forge, even though 343 can't seem to actually design a map properly, they do know what we want in maps. Oh man. Which is good. It's progressive, Their Forge mode is progressive, I would say. I think it's no excuse for the rest of the game, but still.
Yeah, dead bodies is a huge improvement. Block textures have been something I've personally been asking for since Halo Reach.
Can you do block textures?
They finally added them.
Oh!
They add wood, stone. Yeah, they have wood, cobblestone, cement.
Finally. Oh, yeah, no, okay, I saw those, yeah. So,
yeah.
One of the most important parts of the game, which is a good Forge.
Unfortunately,
it doesn't really do anything by itself.
Sean, there is one drawback to them making all these revolutionary changes in Forge, which is it almost makes you not want to Forge for anything, because you know that in the next update they're going to completely flip your map upside down and add a bunch of new shit. Like, I don't even want to go back to my old maps because I built them with the wrong pieces now.
Right.
Like our map of Waterworks that we were remaking.
Right, now you can make it with yeah.
And I have to rebuild the whole map from the very first blocks to make it.
Yes, it creates a lot of abandoned projects, and the fact that the Forge mode is so good and it's so hard to use compared to the previous Forge modes also means that it's not really very interesting, like for me, where I wasn't really that great. I wasn't really that great at doing anything other than building really foreigner-looking objects. And it doesn't really matter now because, like, there's a million other people that are making a million maps, even though nobody's really going to play them. Like, my skills are always going to be underfunded in that game because the Forge mode is so much harder to use now. And you have to spend so much more time on a single map.
So one recommendation I would have for the game as a Forge change, which it doesn't need money, is add the buildings back, because when you're not very experienced at Forge, the easiest thing for you to do to get started on a map is to link a bunch of building pieces together. And it really feels like you've created something. And
right.
It can even be play, but if all you have is basic blocks, you feel like you're getting absolutely nowhere.
Right, I think that the copy and paste idea that they have in the Forge right now is good, but I think that it could be complemented a lot better if they had the ability to save, if you, like, made one of those building pieces. I don't think that they need to make them available in Forge. I think that what they need to do is you need to be able to have a file browser where you can look up objects that you can copy from other people while you're in the Forge mode.
343 also needs to have their own, just that are extremely basic, that are in their own maps.
Well, they already do have pieces that are in their own maps. Like, if you notice the extreme repetitiveness of the Warzone maps, it's because they're made out of base pieces.
Yeah, Warzone buildings. Like, I want those. I want, give me, like, different portions of the Warzone buildings so I can combine the, like, the different halves of the bases and what's the middle base called on the snow map?
Fortress.
Yeah, like give me Fortress.
Yeah.
Let me put like a few little walls in the Fortress so that I can be like, oh, now I have my own little base.
That you can start from, yeah.
And I didn't put almost any effort into it, but at least I have something that I can work with.
Exactly, like there needs to be like a kind of palette for you to forge on, because all the stuff right now is just really so basic that I can't even think of anything. Like, the maps don't inspire me at all, and the maps are kind of way too small. They don't have a Forge world kind of thing.
And then another recommendation for custom games, there needs to be a way to find custom game lobbies that aren't in your friends list. Because the online services are really just splitting the customs community, which is already so small.
Right, well, like I said before, you need to be able to have the you need to be able to see people in matchmaking, like actually see them like you could in Halo 4 and like you could in Halo Reach, where you just go to the side and all of a sudden there's people and you can invite them to parties, and people will invite each other to the parties. I know it's hard to believe, but you know, even I was playing Halo Reach today and I got invited to some random shit that somebody wanted to do even though I wasn't able to do it, you know?
Yeah, and there's one thing, I like it so that if you go into Recents tab, it would actually tell you what the people are doing. So, like, you scroll through Recents tab, you see custom game, awesome, I want to play a custom game. Because this, again, there's so few custom games, you can't get into them.
Right. So, you think that we can come to a conclusion here, because this is, like, 29 minutes now?
Is there one more positive we could think of?
I don't know. I mean, I think they actually managed to balance the weapons in Arena now. I think that Arena's perfect. It's fine. I would really love that there to be a classic Arena where I didn't have to sprint because I hate sprint, but...
Alright, so recap on the positives. Balanced Arena, great forge objects. Negatives, pretty much everything else.
Yeah, I mean, there's not really much to say for the positives. I think that it's just great that they didn't like entirely fuck up the game off the bat. I think that they fucked up the game over time, but it's great that this time wasn't a broken launch, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, it wasn't a broken launch, but it was so bare bones that after a month or two, people were like, so where's the rest of the game?
Well, I still wonder where the hell the rest of the game is at this point, you know?
Yeah, like, where is our linear game modes, you know?
So, I think that overall, I would say that this is just, like, I think that it's definitely one of the worst Halo games that we've had so far, just in total.
Honestly, less fun than Halo 4.
Yeah. I would say that the worst part is that it's I think the reason why it's so horrible is because it's a its base bare bones potential was so good.
That's a great formula.
But they just failed to deliver, you know? They failed to deliver the product that should have been there already. That's just the final, that's kind of like the final straw for me with them at this point, because they failed to deliver a product in a myriad of ways now. Like, it was Halo 4 was like, they delivered a horrible product that I didn't want at all.
But at least you got a lot of playing time out of it. You know?
Yeah.
Because it didn't have a lack of content.
Yeah, and then they released a product that didn't work at the start and still doesn't really work with the Master Chief Collection, and now they released one that isn't even fucking done. I mean, like, it's so confusing of a business strategy for me, like... They don't even stick with one idea at this point. Yeah, so I would say that, like, as a game for Halo, it's definitely one of the worst. And I would say that for games in general, I would say it's, like, average.
If it were a vegetable, it would be frozen peas.
Yeah. Alright, that would be our conclusion. We'll see you guys next time.